Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to properties of chlorides of period 3 elements such as melting point, reaction with water, HCl, conductivity, etc. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question 19. What is the order of increasing melting point of these three chlorides shown? First one is carbon tetrachloride, second is magnesium chloride, and third is phosphorus pentachloride. Now, carbon tetrachloride is a gas at room temperature, so its melting point is very low. Magnesium chloride is giant ionic structure, so it has a quite high melting point. PCl5 is also solid at room temperature, but the melting point is lower as compared to magnesium chloride because the attraction between the ions is not as strong as magnesium chloride. The respective melting point is -22.9 for carbon tetrachloride, 714 degrees centigrade for magnesium chloride, and 160.5 degrees centigrade for phosphorus chloride. So the lowest melting point is of carbon tetrachloride and the highest is of magnesium chloride. So the answer is A. Question 19. Element X is in period 3. It reacts rapidly with water to form an alkaline solution. Which statement about the chloride of element X is correct? Now in period 3, elements like sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon are present, and it says it reacts rapidly with water to form an alkaline solution. Now sodium reacts with water to form sodium hydroxide, magnesium forms magnesium hydroxide, aluminum metal does not react with water, similarly silicon also does not react with water. So it could be sodium or magnesium. Now comparing the reaction of sodium and magnesium with water, we can see that sodium reacts rapidly with water while magnesium reacts slowly. The second part of the question says which statement about the chloride of element X is correct. So it could be the chloride of sodium as NaCl. Let's find out. A. It conducts electricity when molten. So yes, sodium chloride when in molten form it forms ions. So therefore it is a good conductor. B. It has a melting point of less than 100. Now we know that the melting point of sodium chloride is above 700, so this is incorrect. C. It has covalent bonding. No, the bonding is ionic. D. It reacts rapidly with cold water. It does not react, actually it dissociates into ions. So the correct option is A. Question 36. Three test tubes X, Y, and Z each contain water. A small amount of sodium chloride is added to test tube X. Silicon chloride is added to Y. Aluminum chloride is added to Z. After a short time, two drops of universal indicator solution are added. Which statement can be correct? Now we can see that sodium chloride is a neutral salt and it forms sodium ions and chloride ions. Therefore, pH must be equal to 7. For silicon chloride, we know that silicon chloride is acidic in nature. So therefore, it will react with water and form silicon dioxide along with HCl. So the solution will be acidic. For aluminum chloride reacts with water to form aluminum hydroxide along with HCl. Again, the solution will be acidic in nature. Aluminum hydroxide formed is insoluble in water, so the only ions present will be of HCl, so therefore pH will be lower. Moving towards the option, in one, the pH in test tube X is 7. This is correct because it is sodium chloride. The pH in test tube Y is 2, as the solution is acidic, so this could be true. In third, the solution is also acidic, so therefore option 3 is also true. As all three options are correct, therefore answer is A. Question number 12. X, Y, and Z are elements in period 3 of the periodic table. The results of some experiments carried out with compounds of these elements are shown in this table. So we have X. First is the resulting addition of oxide to water. Second is the adding of chloride to water. Third is the result of adding oxide to HCl. Which statement could be correct? Finding out the first one, A says X is aluminum. So the result of adding the oxide of aluminum to water, there is no reaction, as aluminum oxide is insoluble in water. So there is no chemical reaction. So therefore this is correct for aluminum. Now the second reaction is of aluminum chloride with H2O. So we can write AlCl3 plus H2O. This reaction is a hydrolysis reaction in which aluminum plus 3 is formed along with H plus ions. The third is the reaction of oxide with HCl. So aluminum oxide reacts with HCl to form salt and water. So X is aluminum, this is correct. Y is magnesium. So finding out the reaction of magnesium with water, it forms magnesium hydroxide. So this is true for magnesium. Magnesium chloride reaction with water, it dissolves. Magnesium chloride is water soluble, so therefore this is also correct. Third one is that magnesium oxide reacts with HCl to form salt. As magnesium chloride salt is formed, so therefore this is also correct for magnesium. So X could be aluminum and Y could be magnesium. Moving towards option B, X is silicon. First is there is no reaction of silicon dioxide with water. This is true. Second is that silicon chloride will hydrolyze in water. SiCl4 reacts with water to form silicon dioxide and HCl. So this is also true for silicon. Third is that the oxide of silicon reacts with HCl to form chloride. So silicon dioxide plus HCl. As silicon dioxide is acidic in nature and HCl is also acidic in nature, so the reaction will not occur. So therefore B is incorrect. For option C, it says Y is aluminum. Aluminum oxide forms hydroxide with H2O, so this is incorrect, as aluminum oxide is insoluble in water and it does not react. D says Y is sodium and Z is aluminum. Finding out the reaction of sodium in Y, we have sodium oxide plus water. It forms sodium hydroxide. So this is correct for sodium. Second is NaCl is soluble in water. As we know that NaCl is a common salt, so it is soluble in water to form sodium ions and chloride ions. So it is also true for the second one. Third is that the oxide of sodium will react with HCl to form chloride. So Na2O is basic in nature. It will react with acid to form salt along with water. So this is correct for sodium. So Y is sodium is correct. Then let's move towards Z. Z is aluminum. The first one is that aluminum oxide reacts with water to form acid. As we know that aluminum oxide does not react with water, so therefore this is incorrect. So therefore the only correct option is A. Question 13. X and Y are elements in period 3 of the periodic table. The oxide of X is solid at room temperature. The oxide has a giant structure. The chloride of X does not react with water. Argon is the only element in period 3 with a lower melting point than Y. What could be the formula of compound formed between element X and element Y? The elements in period 3 are sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, and argon. The oxides formed by these elements that have giant structure are sodium oxide, magnesium oxide, aluminum oxide, silicon dioxide, while the oxide of phosphorus and sulfur have simple molecular structures. These oxides are also solid at room temperature, so X could be sodium, magnesium, aluminum, or silicon. Second point is the chloride of X does not react with water. The chloride of sodium is NaCl. For magnesium, it is MgCl2. Aluminum chloride is AlCl3. Silicon chloride is SiCl4. Now, sodium chloride and magnesium chloride are ionic compounds and they do not react with water. While aluminum chloride and silicon chloride, they do react with water to form acidic solutions. So element X could be sodium or magnesium. Now let's find out which is element Y. The third point says that argon is the only element in period 3 with a lower melting point than Y. It means that Y is also a gas, so therefore it should be chlorine. So the formula between X and Y could be sodium chloride or magnesium chloride. As only sodium chloride is given, the answer is therefore C. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.